you please stand for the national anthem? Ladies and gentlemen, as principal of Harrison Trimble High School, I welcome you to our 28th graduation ceremony. At this time, I want to introduce you to this evening's platform guests. They are, beginning on my extreme left, Mr. Brian Forsyth, vice principal, Mr. Winston West, vice principal, Mrs. Susan Murray, board of school trustees, Mrs. Cheryl Reed, senior assistant superintendent, Mr. Irving Hanna, board of school trustees, and Mr. Bill McMaster, vice principal, your platform guest for this evening. To my extreme left are the Trimble singers. To my right is the teaching staff. Also on the right side are the presenters of bursaries and scholarships to our graduates this evening, which I might add total approximately $30,000. On behalf of the graduates, I thank you for your financial commitment and support in assisting our students in their future educational endeavors. At this time, Mrs. Judy Jacobson will bring greetings on behalf of the City of Moncton. Mrs. Jacobson?
Mr. Trail and your fellow platform guests, the teaching staff that made this night a reality, and of course, very proud parents and families, and again, of course, the 357 people who are the 1991 graduating class of Harrison Trimble High School. Good evening, bonsoir. It is indeed my pleasure to represent Mayor Leopold Beliveau and my colleagues on Moncton City Council on this memorable evening. It is very special. A high school graduation is a most significant achievement and a milestone in one's life. And I know that your guest speaker for this evening is going to refer to hers and mine a little later. Tonight officially marks the culmination of your high school career. Tomorrow you will become part of a complicated, often frustrating, but always exciting and always in challenging adult world. But don't take those words too seriously. There are those of us who are adults who still sometimes wonder what we're going to be when we grow up. For those of you who will choose to make your lives here in Moncton, you will be choosing a very vibrant city, a bilingual city that was recently named among the 10 best places to live in Canada. And we're all proud of that, and we should be, because it's true. Monctonians have just enjoyed a year-long celebration honoring 100 years of municipal incorporation. During Moncton 100, I'm sure you all had an opportunity to look back on our heritage and growth, but more importantly, I'm sure it gave you all a chance to understand our strengths and appreciate our advantages. Nothing better reflected our history and our future than District 15's production of 100 Footsteps, which of course was held right here, and the second time for our Governor General, Raymond Natition. To me, 100 Footsteps was the highlight of the year. We see an exciting, expanding future for Moncton based on the skills and talents that young adults like yourself can bring to our vibrant economy. You are a very, very important members of our community. On behalf of all the people of Moncton, I commend you on this big step in your personal growth and welcome you most sincerely as fellow citizens of one of the proudest municipalities in Canada. Congratulations and good luck in the years ahead. Felicitations, and do enjoy your graduation. It is a most special evening for you and your family. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Jacobson. At this time, Mrs. Sue Murray will bring greetings on behalf of the Board of School Trustees. Mrs. Murray.
Thank you, Mr. Trail. I'm pleased to have an opportunity to be here tonight, and on behalf of Mr. Hanna and myself, the entire Board of School Trustees of District 15 and our admin staff, to extend congratulations to the graduates and to their parents and to the staff who have all helped to make this evening a reality. With the graduates, I would like to share a short poem that is special to me. It's called Comes the Dawn. After a while, you learn the subtle difference between holding a hand and chaining a soul. And you learn that love doesn't mean leaning and company doesn't mean security. And you begin to learn that kisses aren't contracts and presents aren't promises. And you begin to accept your defeats with your head up and your eyes open with the grace of a woman, not the grief of a child. And learn to build all your roads on today, because tomorrow's ground is too uncertain for plans, and futures have a way of falling down in mid-flight. After a while, you learn that even sunshine burns if you get too much. So you plant your own garden and decorate your own soul instead of waiting for someone to bring you flowers. And you learn that you really can endure, that you really are strong, and you really do have worth. You learn, and you learn. With every goodbye, you learn. As you say goodbye to District 15, we hope you've learned. We hope that what you've learned will serve you well in the future. Goodbye, good luck, God bless. Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Murray. The school year, which is now rapidly drawing to a close, has been one of great change. On a personal note, it has been my first year as principal. The really important change, however, has been the adoption of the semester system, where the school year is divided into two semesters. Students take a maximum of four courses, each 75 minutes in length, in each semester, and can receive up to 8 credits in any one school year. It has been a year of change as well for the teaching faculty, in that they've had to adjust their teaching techniques and methodologies to the longer instructional period. The faculty of Harrison Trimble has responded to the challenge of semestering in magnificent fashion. I wish to thank you, teachers, for your cooperation and understanding this past year, and commend you for your professionalism and teaching abilities. I would be remiss in my remarks if I did not say a few words about what we call at Trimble the Trojan spirit. This is the morale and spirit of Harrison Trimble. You can see it when you look at the trophies in the trophy cabinets. You can feel it when the student body is at assemblies, and you can hear it in the halls during the break between classes. School spirit is really evident when you attend such events as the International Hockey Tournament and the Hoop Classic Basketball Tournament. No small credit for that pride in Trimble is due to the fine teaching and the great support given by our teachers to extracurricular activities. One sad note, which occurred a few weeks ago, was the sudden passing of Harrison Trimble's first principal, Mr. J. Raymond Tibbett. He was the principal from the school's opening in 1961 until his retirement in 1972. His death saddened many of us who knew him and who taught with him. We will have fond memories of this unique man who did much to make our school what it is today. Finally, some words for the graduates. You are my first as principal. You have been a class to be admired for the contribution that each of you have made to the school. Just the fact that as a class, you will receive this evening over $86,000 in scholarships, bursaries, and prizes will attest to that. Among your ranks are many who will be celebrated tonight for academic achievement. Also among your ranks are many unsung heroes who have overcome physical, mental, financial, and other personal disadvantages to become graduates. You all deserve our acclaim. Mothers, fathers, brothers and sisters, relatives and friends of the graduates, I give you the guests of honor here tonight, our graduates, the class of 1991. The Trimble Singers at this time will sing All That I Can Be. Valedictorian Tim Wallace.
Good evening, graduates of 91, honored guests, Mr. Trail, vice principals, teachers, families, and friends. Welcome. Right now, you are all witnessing one, if not the most exciting events of our senior year, graduation. You know, it's really quite amazing how all the hard work, all the worrying, all the cramming, and all the uncertainty has finally culminated into this moment. Can you believe that this is our last official function as regular students of Harrison Trimble High School? After tonight, we'll be known as alumni. Each of us has different memories of Trimble. 3 years, 4 years, 5 years of experiences within the walls of the rambling brick structure on Echo Drive. Remember when we first entered the doors of this fabulous establishment in grade 10 and how nervous we were? We were lowly frosh, and the grade 11s and 12s, they appeared so mature to us. Would we ever be so cool, so self-assured? Then grade 10 flew by, and so did grade 11. Then came our grad year, and with it many changes. We are now in the semester system, with 75-minute periods. Some of us had trouble staying awake for the old 55-minute periods. How are we going to handle 75? But we did. From a student's point of view, semestering has been a large success, largely due to the innovation and the hard work of our incomparable teaching staff. Another big change this year was in our administration, when Mr. Trail replaced Mr. Constantine. We'd like to thank both of you tonight for being fine principals and for ruling Trimble with a firm yet fair hand. Speaking about changes this year, we graduates even get to change where we sat in assembly period, twice in 1 year. But that's another story. The memories that are packed into this year are many, and they'll be locked in our minds and inside the echoing halls of Harrison Trimble High School for many years to come. From Trojan Trek to a football team that was a contender, to the teacher's variety show and the unknown comic, to the student variety show and the traveling Wildberries, to a couple of very extremely competitive basketball, soccer, and volleyball teams, and a hockey team that tried, and to a new cafeteria and spicy French fries, and the life just goes on. Our memories of Trimble are vivid and varied. A large part of that is due to you, the graduates. Your contribution to Trimble has been great, and our school has been the richer for having had you as students. We've been through it all together, and the class of 1991 should hold its collective head high. Throughout my years at Harrison Trimble High School, I've been proud to be a Trojan. Tonight especially, I'm proud. And I know that each and every one of you are proud of many accomplishments that you've deserved to do. Some of you doubted you'd get this far, but you did. Some of your parents worried that you wouldn't make it, but you proved that their worrying was needless. Some of your teachers implied that graduating was not within the realm of possibility. But tonight, here you are. We have to enjoy this brief congratulatory moment while we can, because from this point on, life in the real world outside Harrison Trimble is waiting. Waiting to test us. Waiting to see if we can succeed in the outside world. It won't be easy. There will be no parents to tell us what to do and no teachers to tell us what to study. We have to be our own motivators. For many of us, this is the scary thought. But Trimble has prepared us very well for this task. Whether we continue on with education or enter the workplace, our time at Trimble has provided us with a solid foundation for the future. We're now ready to go. In closing, I wish each and every one of you all the best that life has to offer, and I hope that we all will get together someday at what I hope to be one of our many reunions. In the words of Alfred Lord Tennyson, go forth, strong in will, to strive, to seek, to find, and not to yield. Thank you.
Children and the International Reading Association. Currently, she is involved with the following community services: Director of the Kiwanis Club of Moncton, the Trustee of the Moncton City Hospital, a member of the Education Committee of the New Brunswick Hospital Association, as well as a member of the Regional Mental Health Commission. Tonight's guest speaker is Mrs. Cheryl Reed, Senior Assistant Superintendent of District Number 15. Let's give Mrs. Reed a warm Trojan welcome.
Thank you very much, Jennifer. It was almost longer than my speech. Mr. Trail said I couldn't talk for very long. Proud parents, relatives, teachers and friends, platform guests, but most importantly, the 1991 graduates of Harrison Trimble High School, this is your night, the commencement of a new phase in your lives, a time for parting and a time for new beginnings. I was personally delighted when your principal, Wayne Trail, approached me and asked that I speak to you on this very important occasion in your lives. For a whole variety of reasons, perhaps most significantly, I know a number of you personally, those who have been neighbors and friends to me and my family, but also because I confess it is 30 years tonight since my graduation. 30 years, I am reminded, since Counselor Jacobson's graduation, and 30 years since the graduation of five of your teachers. I won't mention any names. It may seem like a lifetime to young people like you, but for me, I find it hard to believe how quickly time has passed. But time does give us a sense of perspective, a little bit of slowing down and thinking about where we're going. I'm like the old fellow now at the golf tee, lined himself up very carefully, just over the line where you're supposed to start, and made a first effort, missed the ball. The young golf pro, probably a Harrison Trimble graduate, behind said, "You're supposed to get behind that line." He kind of looked at him. The old fellow tried it again. And again, the young pro said, "You're supposed to be behind that line." The old fellow tried it again. And the third time, that young pro said, "Sir, you're supposed to be behind that line." Well, the old fellow turned around to his buddy and he said, "Will you tell that young whippersnapper this is my second time?" He hadn't made it the first. Perhaps time does go slowly for you, but it goes quickly as we get older, even if there's time to think. Now, I must assure you that I would have been a graduate of Harrison Trimble High School, given the location of my home, but it wasn't completed until later in 1961. So I went to that other school, the one down at the other end of Mountain Road. You know, the one with the pink gym. I'll ask you not to think about that. I also had the somewhat ridiculous thought, after speaking to Mr. Trail, that I could say something to all of you that would have some small significance in your future. And with that thought in mind, I decided I would conduct a very limited research among friends, co-workers, and acquaintances in order to obtain hints. I asked myself two questions. Who spoke at your graduation, and what did they say? Well, I assure you, I drew a blank. I decided it must have been just me, but I found I was not alone. I found no one save one individual in a sampling of about 50 who could recall either whom their speaker had been or anything they had said. The one who could, by the way, was Sue Murray's daughter, and her mother spoke at her graduation. Having said that, I suppose I should sit down, but I'll be just a tad too stubborn for that. You'll have to hear me out for a moment at least. For there is one wish for you I feel so strongly about that I'll have to take this opportunity to tell you. I have a hope for you. I want you young people to remain just the way you are, the way I have seen you over the past several years. For by remaining as you are, you will make a difference for all of us in the future. I saw an advertisement in the newspaper last week, and I believe it summed up my thought very aptly. There was a large red print word, "Me," scrawled across the page. the M was crossed out and the W substituted, hence the word we. For the change from the me society to the we world is the direction we must take, in which I see you people as carrying through. I don't really mean that my generation, your parents and guardians, have been inappropriate in our values or in the aspirations we have held for you or for ourselves. In fact, perhaps in our efforts to provide as much as we could, we may have created other problems. Perhaps our desire to get ahead and to have it all for you, to emphasize the individual, has gone a bit too far. Individuals must have their rights and freedoms, but we must work together if we are to improve our world and the lives of our future generations. Our world is plagued by issues of importance. In the world at large, we have hazards caused to our environment, to the ozone layer, by burning rainforests, by burning oil wells, by economic issues, impoverished third world countries, scandalous unemployment rates, and world recession, by violence in the real life and in the media. We even surround ourselves by games that depict violence. And we often put our emphasis on material things, on the labels on our clothing, rather than on the value of participation and efforts to better the world for ourselves and others. But you represent to your families, your friends, your teachers, and to me, optimism for the future. For we have seen in you, the graduates, and in your actions, a change in emphasis, a shift to the we world. Of three kinds of people, those who do, those who watch, and those who don't care, you have shown us that you are those who do. Within your numbers, you represent a wide range of interests, backgrounds, abilities, and values. But you have worked together and provided an example to others. I have seen in Harrison Trimble High School a level of school spirit which would be the envy of any secondary school in any jurisdiction. I was there for your assembly after this year's Trojan Trek. I saw you greet your principal, your teachers, and your peers with a true Trojan welcome. I witnessed your efforts on behalf of the hospital and perceived your own satisfaction with the efforts of your group. Last school year, I saw you greet a disfigured Vietnam veteran with a warmth not replicated in any other school. I have seen you give an attentive hearing and a standing ovation to a group of Halifax students doing a docudrama on the Holocaust. I have seen you accept special needs students into your school with care and tolerance, and have seen you help several of them graduate tonight. You've had one of the strongest intramural programs available in the district. You've won awards for your efforts to raise funding for Big Brothers and Big Sisters. Some of you have won awards from the hospital for your volunteer work. Several of you have gone to the Terry Fox Center. You've won an award for the most outstanding yearbook in New Brunswick. You've supported your interscholastic sporting activities and your athletes. Teams like your basketball group have brought honor to Harrison Trimble High School with a combination of good attitude, excellent athletic ability, and an emphasis on academic achievement and teamwork. You have built new programs in your school: sound and lighting crew, theatrical presentations, outdoor pursuits. And with your efforts in working together and your friendliness toward others, you have laid an excellent beginning for your future. Even families have worked together at Harrison Trimble. Families like the Friends of the Trojans, but even tonight, the graduation of a mother and son team. While you have had the support and cooperation of the staff of Harrison Trimble High School in your endeavors, you have brought about the spirit of togetherness that exists in Harrison Trimble High School. No matter where you go or what you do, your experience in working and growing together will stand you in good stead. Hopefully, you will continue to grow as individuals who know how to work with and to relate to others as you meet the challenges that your future will hold. People who will be individually successful, but who will provide modeling and a leadership in a world geared to we rather than me. I'd like to read you a short story, a case in point, the story of the Canada Goose, or a lesson in getting along. Next fall, when you're graduated and on to the world, and you see the Canada geese heading south for the winter, flying along in a V formation, you might consider what science has discovered as to why they fly that way. As each bird flaps its wings, it creates an uplift for the bird immediately following. By flying in V formation, the whole flock adds at least 71% greater flying range than if each bird flew on its own. For a people who share a common direction and a sense of community can get where they are going more quickly and easily because they are traveling in the thrust of one another. When a Canada goose falls out of formation, it suddenly feels the drag and resistance of trying to go it alone and quickly gets back into formation to take advantage of the lifting power of the one in front. If we had as much sense as the Canada goose, we'll stay in formation with those headed the same way. When the lead Canada goose gets tired, it rotates back in the wing and another flies point. It is sensible to take turns doing demanding jobs with people or with Canada geese flying south. Finally, and this is important, when a Canada goose gets sick or is wounded by gunshot and falls out of formation, two others fall out with that one and they stay with the fallen mate until it is able to fly or until it dies. And only then do they launch out on their own or with another formation to catch up with their group. If we have the sense of the Canada goose, we shall stand by each other like that. On behalf of your parents, guardians, friends, relatives, teachers, the school board, and administrative staff of School District 15, I know you will work together to make a we world. I wish you every success. I have great confidence in you. I know that you will make a difference, that you will carry the spirit of Harrison Trimble forward with you as Trojans. Congratulations and God bless you.
Mrs. Reed, on behalf of myself and Harrison Trimble's graduating class of 1991, I would like to thank you for coming and speaking to us on such a joyous occasion. To thank you for your words of inspiration, I'd like to present you with this small token of our appreciation.
At this time, Randy Taylor is going to sing One Moment in Time. The pain I rise.
Johnson and Joanne McLeod.
Playing a little basketball with friends after a long work week really helps relieve stress.
Being active and including a variety of activities into your daily life can help you physically, emotionally, and socially. And the summer offers an excellent opportunity to get out and get involved. There are so many different sports to enjoy. Hop on your bike and go for an exciting, adventurous ride. Take part in water sports that can give you the splash you need to keep cool. Play some golf or tennis to improve your eye-hand coordination. Or health coach, it's rewarding for you and the kids.
However, being active doesn't mean just sports.
Taking care of your garden can be satisfying and very enjoyable. A relaxing walk at lunch can help you put your job in perspective. Head to the park and throw a frisbee around with the dog, if he'll let you play. Or dance with friends. It's an emotional release, and it can give you more energy. And these are just some of the activities for you to enjoy.
Whether you're with a group, a friend, or by yourself, the main thing is to make active living a part of your daily life. So until next time, keep fit and have fun. Whoa!
Body Break.
Hello? Oh, hi, Mom. Sure, I'd love to go to the ballet with you, but Steve's been working late and we just...
Oh, Scotty, that's an E flat.
I'm sorry, Mom. Maybe next time. Yeah, I love you too. Bye. Oh.
Hi, I'm home.
Oh, you're early.
Yeah, isn't the ballet tonight?
Well, I can't go to the ballet. I'm not even dressed.
Sure you can. I got your dress in the car. I picked it up at the cleaners this morning.
You did?
Yeah, you can change at your mother's. You better hurry.
It's what you do that shows you care. A simple act means more than what you declare. What would you need if it were you? It's not what you say. It's what you do.
Dinner's not started.
I'm a great cook.
Are you sure about
yeah,
all
I'm
this?
Positive. I want you to go and have a good time.
I love you.
I love you, too.
From the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
All right, kids. Somebody order a pizza.
Reached the point in the program that the graduates have been waiting for. It's time for them to receive their diplomas. As parents and friends, we request that you refrain from taking photographs during the actual presentation of diplomas. If you would wait until after the ceremony, Mrs. Murray will be more than willing to stay behind and have photos taken at that time. Arsenal. Lisette Marie Arsenault. Robbie Lee Joseph Arsenault. Jeffrey Joseph Arsenault. Joshua Daniel David Babkirk. Kyla Luann Babkirk, absent. Carl Reginald Bainbridge, absent. Don Kimberly Berry. Michael Bass, honors. Kara Dawn Bastrash. Toby Carolyn Bastrash. Lori Beth Beals. Dana Edward Beaumont, honors. Daryl N. Beers, honors. Rodney Charles Beers, absent. Stacy Lynn Beers. Jeffrey McLeod Bellinger. James Corey Beliveau. Absent. Tammy Lee Bertit, honors. Donald Berube. Jennifer Ann Betts, honors. Kelsey Elizabeth Betts. Andrew David Billing, absent. Tina Black, absent. Heather Lynn Blakeney. Leo Joseph Anthony Boucher. Michael Joseph Boudreau. Christina Maria Buma, honors. Bobby Joe Bourgeois. Carla Michelle Burke. Gary Robert Burke. Georgina Lee Burke. Stacy Lynn Boyce, honors. Winifred Ann Brinston. Andrea Megan Brody, honors. Michelle Lynn Brooks. Christopher Joel Brewer. Christina Ingrid Burley, honors. Jennifer Robin Burns, honors. Claudine Elizabeth Casey. Tracy Jean Cameron. Kimberly Nadine Campbell. Andrew Robert Carl. James Donald Merle Carson. Angela Dawn Carter. James William Carter. Stacy Elena Carter. Jennifer Ray Sorrell. William Edward Roger Chase. Reginald Sean Chitty. Michelle Denise Cole, honors. Paul Hollis Cole, honors. Ray John Kolpitz. Lynn Yvonne Como. Monique Cormier. Renee Chantel Cormier, honors. Charles Rodney Currier. Todd Jason Crosman. Tricia Lane Crozier, honors. Gabrielle Lynn Da Silva, absent. Colin Alexander Dean. Darlene Dawn Demchuk, honors. Lisa Dawn Demers. Adam Lorne Demsey. Stacy Lynn DeWare. Sandy Donald DeWolf. Darren Scott Dillenbeck. Tammy Chantel Dueron. Cindy Elizabeth Dalma. Debbie Mary Dalma. Tracy Lynn Donaher. Krista Blynn Donnelly, honors. Michelle Lee Dorman. Scott Gordon Douglas. Shane Dennis Duthright. Joanne Margaret Duff. Tracy Marie Duff. Troy James Duff, absent. Daniel Larry Dugay, absent. Colin Andrew Philip Duncan. Jason Wayne Dunfield. Tammy Joanne Dunham. Carol Francis Durrell. Denise Ann. Easton. Stacy Lee Elliott. Douglas Darren Ehrman. Hartley Anthony Esterbrooks. Mark Rodney Evans, absent. Corey Scott Evert. Christopher Craig Evert. Bertina Diana Evers. Christopher Kale Faulkner. Travis Robert Fenton. Leanne Margaret Ferguson. Brian Andrew Fisher, absent. Kevin Winston Fisher. James Michael Forsyth, honors. Andrew Duncan Frazier, honors. Lisa Ann Freeman. Mario Gallant. Stephen Gallant. Drew Travis Galloway. Angela Jean Godet. Gaetan Rita Godet. Suzanne Marie Gautreau, absent. Darren James Govan. Kenneth Howard George. Elena Renee Gillis. Melissa I. Gilmore. Tina Marie Mary Gino. Jason Alden Godfrey, absent. Andrea Denise Gauguin. Mark Allen Gauguin. Tammy Bernice Gauguin, honors. Jeanette Mary Gould. Tanya Lynn Gregory. Vicki Nicole Grevenick. Brian Paul Hashey. Marcus Luke Hashey. Carrie Ann Don Halverson. Sherry Granger Hanscom, absent. Sarah Jean Harrison. Tammy Lynn Hatton. Michael Anthony Hayes. Troy Douglas Hebert. Paul William Lee Heisler. Peter John Henkel. absent. Natalie Marie Herman. Daryl Edward Hicks. Kelly Lynn Hicks. Tracy Lee Higgs. Sasha Chantel Hodgson, honors. Scott Andrew Hopper. Anita Dawn Horseman. Clinton Norman Horseman. Jocelyn Heather Horseman. Greg James Hubert. Sylvia Margaret Hunt, honors. Sandra Lynn Inman. Mandy Rose Irwin, honors. Sonia Teresa Isaac Mann, honors. Megan Ann Jerger. Heidi Jean Johnstone, honors. Deanna Lynn Josie. Denise Marie Josie. Kelly Sue Kavanaugh. Ray J. Kelly. Stacy Lee Kelly. Tanya Lee Ann Kelly. Robert Gerald King. Tanya Sherry Kingston. Wendy Lynn Kirkland. Matthew George Clem. Sandra Faye Clem, his mother. Bobby Joe Rachel Lackey. Mark Dale Landry. Nina Nicole Landry. Jody Ann Langell. V. Lee. Charles LeBlanc. Absent. Christopher Charles LeBlanc. Absent. Danny Felix Leonard LeBlanc. Derek Rodney LeBlanc. Javette Marie LeBlanc. Mark Adrian LeBlanc, absent. Mark Charles LeBlanc, absent. Neil LeBlanc, honors and leader of the graduation class. Norma Jean Mary LeBlanc. Ronald Paul LeBlanc, absent. Sharon Allison LeBlanc. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the first half of the 1991 graduating class. At this time, I'll ask Mr. West, Vice Principal, to read out the names of the remaining graduates.
Crystal K. McGuire.
McLaughlin. Christine Joy McClellan. Heather Lynn McNevin. Norbert Sean Melanson, absent. Trissa Lorraine Melanson. Troy Allison Melanson. Kimberly Jean Melvin. Christopher William Mounier. Sarah Lynn Meyer Honors. Robert Gerard Michaud. Harriet Roslia Mills. John Milson. Dara Gail Mitten Honors. Martin Joseph Montplaisir. Tanya Natalie Morey Honors. Kendall David Morton. Jacqueline Ruthann Mowat. Christopher Lee Mowbray. Haley Deanne Mullins. Susan Joy Munn. Melanie Jane Murphy. Marilyn Rose Mudge. Janet Lynn Noss. Lisa Ann Petrie.
Beatrice Elizabeth Poirier. Jason Kenneth Prest, absent. Brent Aubrey Price, absent. Natalie Barbara Price. Natalie Meredith Price, honors. Patricia Gail Price, absent. Derek Norman Prosser.
Thank you.
Christy Lynn Slater. Deanna Nadine Slattery. Heather Lynn Smallwood. Stuart Arthur Smith. James Randall Summers. Jeremy Sean Somerville. Tanya Lynn Santian. Todd J. Soulier. Valerie Lynn Sprague Honors. Mark Edwin Steves. Monty Paul Steves Honors. Susan Wendy Steves. Todd Elijah Steves. Alvin Douglas Stiles. Timothy William Stoddard, absent. Tanya Lee Stothard. Amy Diane Stultz. Joanne Carol Surrett. Wayne Surrett. Colin Bruce Taylor Honors. Randy Lynn Taylor Honors. Robert Allison Tays. Debra Elaine Teague. Carol Louise Terrell. Tamara Jean Terrell. Tammy Lynn Tower. Tina Ann Trenum, absent. Brent Lee Truitt. Jennifer Jean Turgeon. Scott Matthew Underhill. Troy Darrell Underhill. Jason John Urquhart. Joseph Stephen Vassar. Beverly Lynn Vaughn. Lisa Ann Fotor. Dwayne Stewart Riesendorf. Wendy Louise Wagner. Timothy Dale Wallace Honors. Rhonda Sydney Ward. Sean David Ward. Don Marie Watling. Honors. Derek Paul Weatherby. Absent. Todd Jeffrey Wellwood. Shannon Lynn Jason Whalen. Brian Wayne Whippy. John Christopher White. Kerry Whitehead. Krista Ann Whiteley. Darren Walter White. Karen Ann Wiley, absent. Cynthia Sylvia Williams. John Christopher Williams. Richard Williamson. Brenda Marie Wilson. Jason Edward Wilson. Karen Bernadette Wilson. Natasha Marie Wilson. Absent. Maureen Patricia Wendell. Michael John Wood. Scott Clifford Warden. Gregory William Gates Wright. J. Donald Wright. Dale Robin Rye, absent. Cindy Sue Young. Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to present to you Harrison Trimble High School's graduating class of 1991.
Award of $500 to a graduate who has shown high academic achievement and leadership in student activities, the winner, Chris Legere, presented by Mrs. Tippett. Hopper Memorial Prize in the amount of $150 to the graduate of the Work Experience Program with the highest average, won by Tyson Adams, presented by Mrs. Elizabeth Hopper. Lions Club Scholarship in the amount of $1,250 for a student who is going to further his education at university. The winner, Michael Ryan, presented by Mr. Michael Oatway. Harrison Trimble Students Association Bursary, $600, to a graduate with a high academic achievement and leadership in student activities, won by Jamie Forsyth, presented by Ms. Joanne Bellevue. The Moncton CNR War Veterans Limited Bursary of $300, to a worthy student who is going to carry on his education at university, winner Colin Taylor, presented by Mr. Wayne Harrigan. The Margaret C. Bellier Scholarship in the amount of $1,000, awarded by the University Women's Club of Moncton to a female graduate of high standing who is going to enter a degree course at university. The winner, Renee Cormier, presented by Miss Edith Rosenau. Boner Law Chapter IODE Scholarship, $250, to assist a graduate in continuing her education at university. Winner Julie McBain, presented by Mrs. Marjorie Sheehan. St. Bernard's Catholic Women's League of Moncton Bursary, $150 to a deserving student, won by Natalie Meredith Price, presented by Mrs. Christine Harper. Harrison Trimble Faculty Award of $350, presented by the teachers of Harrison Trimble, to the graduate who best exemplifies the qualities of student, leader, and participant in student affairs, and who has made a significant contribution to school life, won by Anita Horseman, presented by Mr. West. Elizabeth Homan School Bursary of $150 to a worthy graduate who is going on to university education, won by Chris Brewer, presented by Mrs. Peggy LeBlanc. Vito's Restaurant Award of $250 to a worthy student to assist in continuing his education, won by Chris Legere, presented by Mr. Granville. Next one is a double one. The Moncton Volunteer Firefighters Association, two prizes, each of $100, to a male and female student who show leadership in extracurricular activities. The winners are Trish Crozier and Tim Wallace. Presented by Mr. William Elaine. $200 donated by Sobeys Stores Limited to assist a graduating student planning to study at a maritime university. Winner Kelly Pettis, presented by Mr. Robert Rothwell. Moncton Music Teachers Association prize of $50 to a graduate who has made an outstanding contribution to the musical life at Trimble. Won by Tanya Morey, presented by Mrs. Elizabeth Chapman. Westmoreland Chapter IODE bursary of $300 to a worthy student to assist in carrying out her studies at university. Winner Julie McBain, presented by Mrs. Leslie Forbes. Another double, the St. Augustus Catholic Women's League bursaries of $300 each to deserving students who wish to further their education. The winners are Renee Cormier and Kevin Rice, presented by Mrs. Jenny Clark. Town Lions Club Award, $400, donated to assist a worthy graduate in pursuing his education. Winner, Colin Taylor, presented by Mrs. Diana Anderson. The Rhoda Hopper Memorial Prize of $200 to a graduate who has shown the qualities of leadership and perseverance in her contributions to the extracurricular life of the school. The winner, Tracy Lightfoot, presented by Ms. Elizabeth Hopper. The Gordon Yard Diesel Shop, bursary of $300, awarded to a deserving student wishing to continue her education. Winner Kelly Pettis, presented by Mr. Royce Gervin. Automobile Dealers Association, $150 to a deserving student, won by Don Watling, presented by Mr. Vince Sunderland. Quintuple scholarship from the Youth Business Institute, which is sponsored by the Atlantic Provinces Chamber of Commerce, the University of New Brunswick, and the Department of Education. And the five winners this year are Dale Roach, Stacy Wetmore, Tracy Cameron, Scott Hopper, and Mike Hayes. These will be presented by Mr. David Blakeney. bursary for a student entering the International Academy of Merchandising and Design, winner Kelsey Betts, presented by Mrs. Heather Morrison. Graduation class bursary, $200 to a deserving student. The winner, Mandy Irwin, presented by Miss Tracy Lightfoot. Dr. O.J. McCulley Memorial Scholarship of $1,000 offered to a student planning to pursue a career in medicine. Winner Neil LeBlanc, presented by Mr. Irving Hanna. Greater Moncton Foundation Incorporated Scholarship, $200 to a deserving student who has participated in a community project. Winner Tracy Cameron, presented by Mrs. Evelyn McKee. I'd like to make a correction. That's Mrs. Evelyn Mackay who is the presenter. The class of 1965 bursary of $100 offered to a deserving student. Winner Mike Ryan, presented by Miss Luke. The Rotary Club of Moncton Scholarships, two each of $1,000. Awarded for high academic achievement, won by Julie McBain and Scott Allen, presented by Mr. Hector LeBlanc. Friends of the Trojans Bursary, $200 to deserving students who are members of the school's cheerleading and or basketball teams. The winners, Randy Taylor and Randy Mahoney, presented by Mr. Ralph Hayes. The presenter is Mr. Roy Boutelier. Now we'll give Mr. Hayes his chance. The Gordon Yard Car Shop Goodwill Benevolent Fund, bursaries of $200 awarded to three deserving students, Anthony McAfee, James Robinson, Colin McKay, presented by Mr. Ralph Hayes. Glen Homan School Association Scholarship, $50 to a deserving graduate pursuing her education at a post-secondary institution. Winner Janice Armstrong, presented by Mrs. Diane Donovan. Birchmount Homan School Bursary, $150. To a deserving student pursuing his education at a post-secondary institution. Winner Tim Wallace, presented by Mrs. Linda Lockhart. Kiwanis Club of Moncton Bursary of $500 to a deserving graduate who has combined a good academic standing with a positive contribution to the school or community, won by Colin Taylor, presented by Mrs. Reed. The Henrietta Potter Scholarship, in the amount of $1,000, is administered through the trustees of St. John's United Church and is awarded to a deserving student who wishes to further her education. The winner, Natalie Barbara Price, presented by Mrs. Sybil Fowler. The Harrison Trimble High School Safe Grad Bursary, $300 to a deserving student, won by Kelly Pettis, presented by Mr. Bob Wallace. Cable 5 Bursary, $500 for a student who will pursue a career in electronics or broadcasting. Winner, Sarah Lynn Meyer, presented by Ms. Sandra Wallace Milner. The Moncton Press Club scholarships of $1,000 each, there are two of them, presented to two students of the graduating class who are planning a career either in print or studying journalism at a Canadian university, won by Sarah Lynn Meyer and Chris Brewer, presented by Mr. Frank Orman. I now have two scholarships that I'll read together before I tell you who got them. First one is the Royal Canadian Legion bursary of $700 for second place finish in the provincial safe driving competition, and also the New Brunswick Police Association scholarship of $400 to a deserving student who wishes to further her education. The winner of both of these, Trish Crozier, and they'll be presented by Mr. Forsyth. The Maritime Beverages Bursary of $500 for a third place finish in the provincial safe driving competition. I don't know how this happened, folks. We all know about women drivers. The New Brunswick Police Association scholarship of $600 to a deserving student, and the winner is Randy Mahoney of both of these. Be presented by Mr. Forsyth. Next, I have two hockey scholarships with the same winner. First one is the Eastern Conference High School Hockey League Scholarship of $1,000 to a student of high academic performance and who has made a significant contribution to high school hockey. The second is the Moncton Coca-Cola High School Hockey Classic Tournament Scholarship, also of $1,000, sponsored by Star Industries, to the most valuable local player in the tournament. The winner of both of these is Daryl Beers. They'll be presented by Mr. Don Mitchell. The Moncton Coca-Cola High School Hoop Basketball Tournament Bursary, $500 to a student of high academic performance who has made an outstanding contribution to high school basketball, won by Tim Wallace, presented by Mr. John Gould. Boys and Girls Club Parents Association bursary of $200, won by Todd Soulier, presented by Mrs. Doris Boudreau. One more bursary that was a late addition to our list. It's not in your program. It's the Moncton Hard of Hearing Association bursary of $100 to a worthy student, won by Sherry Sinclair, presented by Mrs. Marlene Ellis.
$12,000 total, again a $3,000 renewable scholarship for each year of university, won by Andrew Fraser and presented by Mr. Frank Haynes. University, an award in the amount of $7,000, which consists of a $2,000 scholarship renewable for a total of 2 years, plus a $3,000 national bursary won by Mr. Scott Allen and presented by Mr. Perry Kekkonen. An award of $4,000, a $2,000 scholarship renewable for the first 2 years of university, won by Chris Legere, presented by Mr. Sean Stokes.
Editor of the award-winning 1990 yearbook, and he was also the co-editor of this year's book.
For the past 3 years, he was present at virtually any school function with his camera in hand. In addition to the many hours he devoted to the success of the yearbook, this young man has played on the school rugby team for 3 years, the soccer team for 1 year, as well as serving on the student council for 1 year. This year, he ran for the position of graduation class president and valedictorian, and he served as a member of the grad class committee. In addition to these many hours of service, he has consistently maintained above average marks in the classroom. Ladies and gentlemen, we take great pleasure in presenting Mr. Chris Brewer. The next distinction award was presented to a young lady who has been active in the athletic and non-athletic life of Trimble. She has been a member of the girls' soccer team for 3 years, the field hockey team for 3 years, and the badminton team for 2 years. She also served as the manager for the girls' basketball team for a period of 1 year. And in the non-athletic field, this young lady was a contestant in the Miss HTHS pageant. She was a co-chairperson of this year's Safe Grad Committee, and she served on the student council. She was also a volunteer worker with the Down Syndrome Children. This young lady was also selected to represent Trimble at the Legion Leadership Camp, the Red Cross Youth Symposium, and the Forum for Young Canadians in Ottawa. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Anita Horseman. Recipient of this next award is a very, very deserving student. This presentation is indeed unique in that this young man is the first person to receive this award while being a Trimble student for only 2 years. This is an outstanding accomplishment. This student is a high honors graduate who has played 2 years of football, 2 years of volleyball, 2 years of basketball, and 1 season of rugby. This year in football, he was a member of the All-Province All-Star team, and he was selected as the most outstanding offensive player in the entire province. In addition to these athletic accomplishments, this young man has played key roles in our school drama presentations for the past 2 years. In addition, he has served as a math and physics tutor. Further, in the field of physics, he received a National Award of Merit for his ranking on the secondary school physics examination. This student was also Trimble's selection to the Adventures in Citizenship Conference in Ottawa, and while there, he was selected to represent the province in a speech-making capacity to the Governor General. In the area of public speaking, this person was the winner of the Regional and Provincial Lions Club Speak Out Contests. I trust that you will agree with me, this young man has provided tremendous service to Harrison Trimble High School. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm pleased to present Mr. Chris Legier. This next student epitomizes the image of a true Trojan, accomplishing an incredulous amount in her 3 years of high school. She has been a member of many committees, including the Intramural Committee and most recently the Grad Committee. Though participating in virtually all Trojan activities, she has maintained her position on the honor roll for 3 years. She has also been a math tutor. An avid competitor, this student could be seen at bat as a member of the girls' softball team or cheering lustily as the center blocker or as a volleyball ref. Her leadership abilities are evident on and off the court. She was chosen to attend the Terry Fox Center after an impressive stay at the leadership camp in Mount Ellison. No stranger to responsibility and hard work, this student has had an excellent experience in leadership positions, serving as president of the Key Club and most recently as secretary treasurer of the grad class in 1991. This student has also served this year as the student council treasurer and extremely busy in all fundraising capacities. This next Distinction Award winner, deservedly, to Miss Tracy Lightfoot. This next Distinction Award was awarded to a very worthy student. She became diversely involved in Trojan events almost immediately upon coming to Harrison Trimble. She has been an essential member of the girls' field hockey team for the past 3 years. We have also experienced the pleasure of listening to her entertain us at various Trimble functions. Although busy as a member of the world-renowned Hillsboro Girls Choir, she has maintained an excellent standing on the principal's honor roll for all 3 years of high school. She took time out of her busy schedule and represented Trimble at the Terry Fox Center in Ottawa. Although her grade 11 year was marred by an accident, we have witnessed a remarkable reciprocation of concern and kindness for the students at Trimble. Although she served as a student class rep, her service and commitment cannot be compared to the long hours of dedication and organization she has put into this year as your student council president, Miss Julie McBain. This next young lady has also been a very active Trojan for the past 3 years. She has been an honors student in each of her 3 years at Trimble. In addition, she has played basketball for 3 years, volleyball for 3 years, and badminton for 1 year. She also took time from her schedule this year to help coach badminton at the junior high school level. In the non-athletic area, this young lady was a member of the New Brunswick Safety Council for 1 year. She won second princess honors in the Miss HDHS pageant last year. She has been a member of the grad committee, was a key member of this year's intramural committee. As you have seen earlier this evening, she is a very active member and a very accomplished member of the Trimble Singers. She has served on the student council and has also been very actively involved as a math tutor. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Randy Taylor. This next Trojan has been very active in student activities. She has been an honor student and is a very competitive varsity athlete. In her grade 10 year, she was a member of the school volleyball team. In grade 10 and 11, in grades 11 and 12, she participated on the field hockey and soccer teams. Also in grade 12, she was a member of the school's badminton team. In addition to these activities, she has been a key member of the girls' basketball team and has served as the captain of that team this season. This young lady has also been a member of the New Brunswick provincial team for the past 3 years. She was chosen to represent Trimble at the Terry Fox Center last fall and also has been a valuable member of the SafeGrad committee. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present Miss Jennifer Turgeon. Recipient of this final award has been extremely committed and very active in his 3 years as a Trojan. This young man has been a high honor student in each of his 3 years. He has been a member of the school soccer team for the past 3 years, and this season was selected as his team MVP. As well, he has been a prominent member of the school's basketball for 3 years and has served the final 2 years as co-captain. As a basketball player, he has represented New Brunswick for 4 consecutive years on provincial teams. In addition, he has received numerous All-Star Awards in addition to being named to the All-Province team for each of the past 2 years. In addition to athletics, he has represented Trimble at the Terry Fox Center, the Legion Leadership Camp, and at the National Conference on Youth and Crime Prevention. This person has also been a key member of the Trimble Drama Productions for the past 2 years. As a grade 11 student, he was selected as Trimble's Male Athlete of the Year. He has also served on the Student Council and SafeGrad committees. He has has this year been elected as the president of the grad class, and he is also the valedictorian for the 1991 class. He's also received a distinction certificate and a medal in the University of Waterloo's math competition. Ladies and gentlemen, to a truly deserving young person, Mr. Tim Wallace.
This time, we are ready to sing the school song one last time.